Last Saturday, California software engineer John Tyner was passing through San Diego Airport security on his way to South Dakota to hunt pheasant. After refusing the advanced imaging full-body scan, the TSA agent notified him he'd receive a pat-down. John recorded on his cell phone camera what happened next.
I'll be doing a standard pat-down on you today, using my hands going like this.
All right.
Body. Also, we're going to be doing a groin check. That means I'm going to place my hand on your hip, the other hand on your inner thigh, slowly go up and slide down.
Okay.
I'm going to do that two times in the front and two times in the back.
All right.
And if you'd like a private screening, we can make that available for you also.
We can do that out here, but if you touch my junk, I'm going to have you arrested.
Since then, Don't Touch My Junk Guy's video has been viewed on YouTube over 700,000 times, and the San Diego TSA chief announced that John faces fines up to $11,000. Joining me now, the man who recorded that video, John Tyner, and civil liberties tallest and loudest ally, comedian, magician, Penn Jillette. Thanks for joining us, guys. John, what exactly are you charged with here? How do you face a fine of $11,000?
There haven't actually been any charges at this point, but it's my understanding that the charge would be leaving the airport after entering the screening area without completing the screening process.
And the my understanding of the law there is that when you're in the screening process, you can leave. They can't physically apprehend you if you leave, but it is a little bit like going through a stop sign. They can also kind of write you a ticket for that, and you can get in effect a fine in the mail for it.
Yeah, it's my understanding that it's a civil charge, not a criminal one. So, you know, like you said, and I've even read on TSA's website that you can opt out of it and leave, but they're, you know, at least on the website they don't mention this fine. But yeah, it's my understanding that at least now, that if you leave, you might be subject to a fine.
All right, let's listen to what TSA Director John Pistol told the Senate committee yesterday about the reasons for these pat-downs.
When I came on as administrator in July, I looked at what we were doing to address the threat posed by the 1225 Abdul Mateen, the underwear bomber. One of the things they found as a common denominator was when they were able to get through the covert testing, were able to get through security, it was largely because we were not being thorough enough in our pat downs.
Penn, your reaction?
Mine are all not practical, but rather philosophical. I think that we should have more freedom, and always going for more freedom is a good idea. I think it is security theater. I don't think it really protects us. I mean, 8 years ago, I was going on a flight, and they reached up and would reach around my crotch without asking me. Now, everybody knows that anyone can touch my crotch that wants to, but I want to be asked first, you know? And
you're so old-fashioned that way.
You don't need movies. You don't need to take me to a movie or take me to dinner. I just want to be asked first. They just reached up and grabbed, and I asked the police there if that was assault. And I think when John says, you know, don't touch my junk, if they go further, I think that's assault, and he should at least be able to split. I would also like to think that live free or die still meant something and we cared about freedom. But if we're not going to care about freedom, at least let a guy split who doesn't want his crotch grabbed.
John, I want you to listen to what Congressman John Mica said about this on this show earlier tonight.
Sure.
I think the TSA has overstepped its bounds. I have no problems with using the body advance imaging or pat downs, but it shouldn't be done for primary screening. It should be targeted people who pose a threat, who set off some alarm or on a watch list.
Now, John, he is the Republican who's going to be chairman in the new Congress of the Transportation Committee. That sounds like, I think, from your perspective, possibly a voice of reason entering this from Congress.
Yeah, I would agree. I would tend to agree with what he had to say. You know, I don't think that people should be subjected to a virtual strip search when there's no probable cause or reasonable suspicion for it.
Now, Penn, you move through airports recognized, I think, most of the time as the great celebrity, unthreatening celebrity that you are. but still, you can't resist beating up on the TSA whenever you get a chance. Do you get special treatment going through because they know who you are?
When I wrote about this 8 years ago, they tried to give me special treatment, and I didn't want it. They asked me, and I don't know if they would ever do this now, but they actually took me aside after I said I'd like to talk to the police and said, if you just call us in advance when you're going to fly, we can make this much easier for you, Penn. But since then, I've been carrying, of course, a security edition of a metal copy of the Bill of Rights. So when you go through, this security edition will set off the alarm, and then you can actually say to the TSA employee, oh, I'm sorry, here, take my rights.
So let me just get that straight. What I'm looking at there is the Bill of Rights written on metal so
yes.
that it will set off the screening alarm.
Yeah, it's
and then,
called
then you
security
have to,
edition, yeah.
Yeah. And so then they ask you, what's that?
And you just say, oh, it's my rights, you can take it. It accomplishes nothing whatsoever. It's strictly performance art. It's for yourself. It's so that every time you go through TSA, you remind yourself, this is what I'm giving up. It will not accomplish anything. It won't get you through faster. It won't get you through much slower. It won't change the laws. But at least in your heart, you're able to say that sentence that's so important to say, here. Take my rights.
John Tyner, are you holding up one of these things,
yeah,
too?
Yeah, I've got one also.
So wait, were you looking for trouble, John Tyner, when you went through that?
No, actually, my wallet, I stuffed it in my bag so that it wouldn't set off the metal detector.
All right, we got to go. John Tyner and Penn Jillette, thank you both.
All right, thank you.
You can have The Last Word online at our blog, thelastword.msnbc.com, and you can follow my occasional tweets at Lawrence. That's tonight's Last Word. Countdown is up next.